Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we'll discuss a question which says that suppose a person's resting blood pressure is 130 over 90. If this person's resting heart rate is 60 beats per minute, write the sine function that represents the blood pressure for t seconds, then graph the function. What will be the blood pressure when t is equal to 22? Now, before starting the solution of this question, we should know a result. And that is, periodic phenomena using trigonometric function is of the type y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole plus k, or y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole plus k. Now this result will work out as a key idea for solving out the given question. Now let us start with the solution of the given question. Now here we are given that a person's resting blood pressure is 130 over 90. It means that the blood pressure oscillates between maximum of 130 and minimum of 90. Now let P be the blood pressure and T be the time in seconds, and it is a periodic function. Now we have to write sine function that represents the blood pressure P and time t seconds. Now we know that periodic phenomena using trigonometric function is of the type y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole plus k. Now here we have to write sine function that represents the blood pressure P and time T. So it will be of the form P is equal to A sine of B into T minus C the whole plus K, where K represents vertical shift, absolute value of A gives amplitude, C represents phase shift, and period is equal to 2 pi upon absolute value of B. And here K also gives us the midline. First of all, let us find equation of midline. Now here maximum blood pressure is 130 and minimum blood pressure is 90. So here midline is at P is equal to, now here P is representing the blood pressure, and midline is at P is equal to minimum value plus maximum value whole term 2, which is equal to 130 plus 90 whole term 2, and this is equal to 220 upon 2, which is equal to 110. So midline is at P is equal to 110. Now we know that midline is at Y is equal to K, and here we have the midline, which is at P is equal to 110. So here K is equal to 110. It means vertical shift is equal to 110. And now let us find amplitude. Now amplitude is given by absolute value of A, which is equal to absolute value of maximum value minus minimum value whole upon 2, which is equal to absolute value of, now here, maximum value of blood pressure is 130 minus minimum value is 90 all upon 2. This is equal to absolute value of 40 upon 2, which is equal to absolute value of 20, which is equal to 20. Therefore, A is equal to 20. Now let us find period. Now period is given by 2 pi upon absolute value of V. Now given, heartbeat is 60 beats per minute. That is 60 beats in 1 minute, that is 60 beats in 60 seconds. Thus, 1 beat in 1 second. Therefore, there is 1 heartbeat or 1 cycle in 1 second. That is, after every 1 second, heartbeat repeats. So, period is equal to 1 second. This implies 2 pi upon absolute value of V is equal to 1, which further implies 2 pi is equal to absolute value of V, and this implies B is equal to plus minus of 2 pi. Here, positive or negative value depends on whether we start a cycle with maximum value or minimum value. That is, when we start a cycle with maximum value, then we take positive value. And when we started with minimum value, then we take negative value here. Now let us take here B is equal to 2 pi. Now there is no phase shift. Therefore, here C is equal to 0. Now here we have K is equal to 110. A is equal to 20. B is equal to 2 pi. And C is equal to 0. Now putting all these values in this periodic function, which is representing the blood pressure P and time T, we get P is equal to A, that is 20, sine of B, that is 2 pi into T minus C the whole. Now here C is 0, so it will be 20 sine of 2 pi T plus K, that is 110. Now let us graph this periodic function. Now for making the graph, we will take time T is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on horizontal axis, and blood pressure P is equal to 20, 40, 60, 80 and so on vertical axis. First of all, let us draw horizontal line, that is midline, at P is equal to 110. So we have drawn a horizontal line at P is equal to 110. And then we have drawn dotted lines on maximum and minimum values, that is at P is equal to 130 and at P is equal to 90. That is, using amplitude is equal to 20 units above midline and 20 units below midline. Now, as there is no phase shift, so we start with T is equal to 0. And on y-axis, we get 110. So, we start from this point. And always keep in mind the graph of sine function while drawing periodic phenomena using sine function. Just draw the same way, reaching maximum point at 130, that is at y is equal to 130, and minimum point at y is equal to 90, and then again reaching the midline. Thus completing the cycle at t is equal to 1. And now we will repeat the cycle extending on both sides. So this is the required graph of the periodic function p is equal to 20 sine of 2 pi t plus 110. Now we have to find that what will be the blood pressure when t is equal to 22. Now we can make use of graphic calculators to graph a function when its equation is known. So once we find the equation, we can graph the periodic function from graphic calculators. Now the following graph will be made for the function p is equal to 20 sine of 2 pi t plus 110 with the help of graphic calculator. Also we can predict values of t, that is x, and p, that is y, using graphic calculators. Now we have to find p when t is equal to 22. Now we can see from graphic calculator that for t is equal to 22, we have p is equal to 110. So the blood pressure will be 110 when t is equal to 22. And here, this point on the curve shows that when time t is 22 seconds, then blood pressure is 110. So this is the solution of the given question, and that's all for this session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.